Hi, Michael.
Hello everyone, my name is Michael. Me and my colleague, Dr. Triadafilos Karabinis, would like to present you the newly born Cardiodental Academy. The goal of the Academy is to present you implant systems, and in such a case, we will present you the root system. And we would like to show you cases, we would like to share your experiences, your problems, and your succeeded cases as well. We are going to have some more events in the future, both online and in
we are going to have courses generally. Yes. We are going to have webinars. We are going to do courses around Greece.
Okay, almost everywhere. So,
and as we said, we are thinking to do like something like implantology master, let's say, after COVID period. Correct, Michael?
Yes, that's fine. That will be very nice. And we are looking forward to it. So today, Triadafilos, you are going to present us the root system?
Yes, we are going to. We are key opinion leaders of root system. I'm in North Greece, Michael, he's a key opinion leader for South Greece. So this is our system. We have chosen this system because of a lot of benefits that it has. I'm going to do a very short presentation just to start our courses. The same course that was done by me in Greek now is going to be in English. I will start and Michael can add whatever he will think. It's going to last 15 minutes, not more.
Okay, so we're good to go.
Yes, Root Company is a company based in Europe, in Switzerland, with a very big quality factory. We are going, first of all, to check our two-piece implant. Two-piece implant, we call it Root-R. It has the same prosthetic platform for all diameters, even if it is slim, if it is wide, or if it is short, 6 millimeters, we are going to have we are having the same platform, so it makes the system easier. This happens because of the total conical connection. It is a total conical Morse connection, which does not allow, as we know, the connection, the conical connection is very stiff, and it doesn't allow the bacteria penetration or screw loosening. This is the strongest connection in the market. We know that the space between the abutment and the implant is 0.7 micron. That means that even a small bacteria of 1.5 micron it cannot pass in the implant. So this is very important and for the bone stability. We have a small hexagon. This hexagon, it doesn't give retention, it's just for the prosthetic position. All the retention is coming from the cone of the abutment and the implant. So we have this thin cone. The benefit of this is the very thick walls that the implant has, even in the smaller diameters, like 3 millimeters or 3.5, it is very durable. All the implants of root system, they have a SLA surface. It means SLA surface, but the sandblasting, it happens with ceramic particles and not with nevrotoxical aluminium oxide particles. We have seen in the past that many companies, they are using the aluminium oxide, but in the healthcare industry, we have seen that aluminium oxide, it can be nevrotoxical. So root implant system does not use, for all the kind of implants that we have, we don't use aluminium oxide particles for sandblasting the surface. One other big benefit is that all our abutment surfaces and parts of the implant, they are anodized. What is the meaning of anodized? It is a super polished part. It happens with a specific way. So it's very biological for the soft and the hard tissues. We are going to analyze this more to upcoming courses that we are going to do. Very important, as you see here, is the big switch platform. As I said, this platform is created by narrow abutments. they have about an inclination of 15 degrees that allowed the bone to grow over the implant, so we will not have perimplantitis. We are going to analyze all this biological data, what is the protocol that we need to follow, why a two-piece implant like Root with Morse connection is better than the other implants, and why we should choose the Root. Let's say we've started as a doctors of Root, and after we start having commercial ties with the company, the aim of me and Michael is to find a good company. That was the first aim, and after the commercial part. As I've said, the Morse connection, the big switch platform, and the design of the abutment is the secret of zero perimplantitis. It is a conical implant, self-tapping implant with deep threads, suitable for immediate loading protocols. And there is a traumatic ending here, and it's very appropriate for the sinus lifts too.
And for immediate extractions and immediate implant placement as well.
Yes, yes, exactly. And we will show you with Michael that 5.5, it has changed the shape to be much and more more appropriate for after extraction sockets. We see here the anatomy of all the implants, number diameter 3 up to 5.5. As I said, 5.5 has a different now design. As you see, we have a length from 6 to 16 and diameter 3 to 5.5, always the same platform. Now, 5.5 implant, different design. There are much more indications comparing with the old design. You see that there is when we have implants of 5.5 implants with length 10 and more, we have in this anodized neck, it is about 1.5 millimeters, if I remember well. That makes the implant for purposes. For example, it can be placed with protocol of subcrestal placement, but it can be placed as a tissue level implant. And if we take the new bibliography of the last years, this anodized neck is going to delay the periodontitis, and it will stop it. We can have bone here up here, first switch platform and the second switch platform here at the rough surface with the thread. So it's, let's say, double protection. Of course, this design is difficult to be done in thinner implants because they will break, they will have very thin walls. So this design will be 5.5 and in the future in 4.8 implants. Yeah, tell me, Michael.
So the implant has got a platform switching by itself?
Yes. Double platform switching. You see here and up here the same.
And this is very friendly for the edges of the bone?
Yes, for the cortical. It is like the bone design. The bone design is like this. It is like a roof. It becomes wider and then again thinner. So this is the anatomy of the bone. The neck here is not 5.5. I forgot to tell that the neck is 4.1. So it is undistressed neck. It doesn't stress the cortical bone. So you have many options to place it subcrestal at the same level with the bone, a tissue level, but even the periodontitis, it will go slow. Even if the bone, it will reach the first thread, again, we have the biological concept because there is this super polished neck. This is a big issue that we are going to analyze in our next webinars. This is the total conical connection, 5 degrees. The Morse connection, the most friendly connection, all the protocol of zero bone loss.
Bone loss.
Yes, it is. This concept is supported on this criteria of Morse connection of 10 degrees, a total 10 degrees, because it is 5 degrees. There are many people, they say, oh, this implant have conical connection is 16 degrees conical connection. And they mean 16 degrees only the one side. It is totally 32 degrees that this is not a conical connection. It is not a real conical connection. The retention, again, it comes from the hexagon and not from the conical connection.
Is that a Morse connection?
It is not a Morse connection. We are going to show the why is very useful the Morse connection in our next presentation. Now, we have the tissue level implant of roots, root M and root MS. Root M is a tissue level implant, but the connection is not the internal or external hexagon, is a direct multi-unit connection. So we have a multi-unit, but we are not doing a three-piece implantology like we are doing with the normal multi-unit with a two-piece implant. We have a two-piece implantology with a multi-unit. And because we have multi-unit connection, it is easier to correct this parallelism directly. Because if we have two implants with internal connection that they are like this, it is very difficult to correct the parallelism. You will need to cement your prosthetics. So let's conclude. We have multi-unit with the thickest screw in the market is 2.5, unbreakable. And there is the ability to correct this parallelism, this multi-unit up to 60 degrees. It's too much.
You still have platform switching?
You have here the neck platform switch. The multi-unit is connected with the implant, so the implant doesn't have gap inside. Even the 3 millimeter implant is very difficult to break. It's unbreakable. As you said, it has the switch platform and the 15 degrees inclination of the neck. The unique the unique threads that they are like a knife. They don't create high friction. Great initial stability, large surface of degradation. As we said, we have SLA surface sandblasted with ceramic particles here too. And we have this thin end that we can use it for nerve bypass techniques. This is very important. We are going to show cases in our next webinars.
And the bone preparation for this implant is very, very preservative. So you don't have to prepare the bone for the whole width of the implant. You just prepare the bone for the main trajectory of the implant, and then the threads are shaped like this and they get involved in the bone.
Yes, exactly. This is the easy thing. And there are many diameters of this implant. They start from 3 up to, at the moment we have 3 up to 5. In the future we are going to have wider diameters. Length could start from 6 millimeters up to 20 millimeters. We have root S. Root S is the same implant with a small multi-unit for a small diameter, more aesthetic when we need more aesthetics, mainly for the anterior region. And now we have the one-piece implant of root. It is very important because we can have protocol, not only cemented protocols, but we have protocols, telescopic protocols with Morse connection cut. You don't need a screw or cement. And there is a unique way how you can remove this telescopic crown we are going to analyze. Again, we have a long hygiene neck with switch platform. Very friendly to the bone. You need, of course, to place the neck in the bone. It is unbreakable, even in small diameters. Again, you don't have a problem of this implant to break or something, even the small diameters. Of course, when we are doing a full mouth and we have many small diameters, we need to use much more implants concerning with wider implants.
So yeah. You place the implant in the bone and then you place the 1.5 millimeters neck in the bone as well?
Up to 3 millimeters you can place.
Up to 3 millimeters in the bone?
All the neck. There are telescopic cups that they are shorter. So if you need that to be placed deeper, you can place shorter conometric cups.
So we don't have to cut the full length of the abutment.
Yes. If you have bone, it can be created and bone on the bone on the abutment too. There is a big philosophy that we are going to analyze in later webinars. And if you want to follow a simple tooth protocol, you can prepare the abutment like being a tooth and creating samphir or whatever you want to create. The problem with one-piece implants, it is that the abutment is there. You need to check how you will place them prosthetically to place them correct as much as you can, and then to follow a correct plan. If you know how to use a one-piece implant, is a very, very, you can have very nice results. But the philosophy is a bit different than the two-piece implants. It is something, if you start to implant one-piece implants, that it needs to be discussed. It is, again, an SLA implant with some blasting with ceramic particles, ideal design, again, for nerve bypass. There is the ability for the neck of the implant to be bended with a special instrument up to 15 degrees to correct disparallelism. And I think that's it. We are going to have more details in the future and about the implants. You have, again, all the diameters, 3 up to 5.5, 6 to 20 millimeters length. It's important for these implants to place many times a longer implant, especially when you need initial stability and you want to place a temporary tooth, mainly for the front teeth, etc., etc. But again, you can follow a delay loading protocol. It's not, it doesn't mean that you have the abutment that you need to load the implant direct. I'm using this implant a lot of time and for molars, the wider implants of this type, and I don't load it. Or I'm placing a cup like a healing abutment, only this.
So you've got the possibility to place a healing abutment on top of the abutment to prepare the soft tissues?
Yes.
To widen them?
You can, you have the conometric cups or healing abutments that they are like barrels. You can use systems like Cervico. You can change the shape of this. You can do whatever you want. It's matter how much time you want to spend in every type of implants. It's what time I want to spend. Do I want to do it cemented because it's cheaper and faster and try to prepare it with samphir, etc., etc.? Do I want to use a telescopic connection, but that needs more time, more money? It depends what the doctor would like to do every time. Yes. You can see bad implantology with one piece implant, with two piece implant, and good implantology with one piece implant and two piece implants. Every implant has an indication. One piece implants, they are very good after ortho treatment when teeth are missing, with very narrow spaces,
laterals,
premolars,
that they are missing.
Yes, we found many, many solutions, very narrow spaces for central lower incisors. That is, it is not possible to give better aesthetics only with these implants because you haven't the whole of the screw. Sometimes the whole of the screw for the lower incisors is so big. It's so big.
It's the whole tooth.
Yes. And sometimes I'm for the lower incisor, I'm preparing this abutment. I use cement. Because the space is very small, even for the conometric cup. Even for the cup, the space is small. So I prepare, I'm doing a nice samphir, and I'm doing a very good cementation. And the aesthetics with the zirconium crown is the best. Is the best. You cannot have better.
And the impression you get is an impression like the tooth impression.
Like a tooth. Like a tooth. And you have a good cast model with pattern resin, or you can scan direct on the prepared abutment, and that's it, like a tooth. And this is the easy point. Now, we will go to the pterygoid implant that I'm using the last 2-3 years with the help of my friends of the international key opinion leaders of Henry Diedrich and Dainius Karpavičius that I think they have designed this implant. It has much more benefits than the other pterygoid implant because they are following the anatomy of the pterygoid region. The multi-unit is connected again here with the implant because the advantage of the connection of the multi-unit of the implant is that there we have a soft bone. We don't want to place, remove the multi-unit, turn it, or we will destroy this soft bone. You need to place the implant and leave it there. So this is the benefit of the multi-unit connection, direct, and one piece. And because of the design, we need only one drill. We can drill even manually. You see that the design of the implant, these square threads, that they are very appropriate for the soft bone, and the very thin penetrating tip that it will penetrate the very hard bone of the pterygoid region. It is something that we are going to analyze in other webinars, and we are going to show you how it is, easy it is. You avoid the sinus lifts. It is not difficult to place. It is not a zygomatic implant, and you can avoid this all on four with big cantilevers. You can add these implants at the back. 95% of the patients, they have bone there, and you can have very good prosthetics without cantilever. It is a very strong implant. It is supporting the pterygoid region that you have hard bone, and you have a long implant with good stability. The gums there, they are very thick normally. It is very difficult to have periodontitis in the future there because of the gums, even if it is not placed very well, the implant.
Can you use it for immediate loading?
No. Because I'm new, I'm using it the last 2 years. I haven't used it yet for immediate loading. We have some cases that we are going to show. Many people are using it for immediate loading. And it's a very good tool. It depends on the doctor how he would like to use this kind of implant. So that was our short presentation, Michael. I don't know if you want to add something. Thank you, too.
Not actually, it was a very nice introduction to the root system for all of these implants. And it would be very nice to get into some more details for each kind of implant separately in the future.
Michael, he's going to present us how you do teeth in a day. One of our next courses with root R and a combination with root M or using only root M, the tissue level implants that we have with the multi-unit. And together with Michael, we are going to analyze and the Morse connection. These are going to be our next two courses. So okay, thank you a lot, Michael. Nice. And
thank you,
we will be back soon. Bye-bye. Ciao.
See you all. Bye-bye. Bye.